gotta go. Like when I say rock, paper, scissors, shoot, you gotta stick out. Scissor, rock smashes scissors, but paper grabs rock, but Zeke scissors cuts through paper, okay? Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock.
So, I took a family trip over to see our project in progress here in the evening. You guys have got some great progress here, looking really good. I'm really excited to show you this. First off, we've got our screed bed here. The guys got our screed bed out for the under area here, which is super cool. You can see the screed bar that we use there, that 1-inch iron pipe. That gives us that 1-inch setting bed of these number 9 stones, which is perfect. And this is number 9 stuff is what you want size-wise if you're going to do this system, dense graded base or open graded like that. And then it's number 9 or at the most number 8. Number 8 stone is going to be, the biggest chip. It's going to be like, this is probably two. That's really bigger than number 8 should be. But any bigger bedding material than that, you're going to have sand problem with your poly sand getting down in there. So. Okay, so the big reveal here, which I just cheated it because everybody saw it, but this is our landing area that I'm absolutely in love with. I wanted this, all this brick, this landing area at a 45 degree angle, of the herringbone that is, so that it, I guess, gave some contrast to the lines of the building, which is super cool. And this is just looking phenomenal with this natural sandstone. We'll come in and power wash all this as we go. Then you can see through here, we got our sidewalk from the fiasco. They're having to pick it up and redo it. We got that done. And then the guys are have gotten this laid in. Now, Bo ran this herringbone straight out from the house, which is pretty interesting. I envisioned it going, actually, the main line going 90 degrees to this. But I like what he did there. I think that's pretty cool. So... very happy with that turnout. Here comes the rest of the inspection brigade here. Careful.
We're inspecting the job site.
Okay, do you approve?
No.
No, stop it now. They got their line out there for their curvature. And just looking phenomenally sharp. Got a dumpster here for our cut pieces, which is really handy that every time we're making a cut, it just gets chucked in the dumpster here. And that can go and get dumped over the hill. Super awesome sauce. These brick tongs are really handy to have to move clay brick. I'll get this set up the way it should be so you can see. We're big fans of using tools to move stuff as easy as possible, but you grab a brick tong like this and now you can move a whole band of brick like that and get it right up where your work area is. And that works out really nice. So make sure you got the tools. Just simple basic stuff like that makes a big difference. Of course, all our big machinery here to make sure this happens. But looking super, super good. All our little screed bars and grade pins, making sure this gets laid out the way it should. So that's it here, folks. The guys are doing real good. Looks really nice. Really happy with it. This main area is going to be awesome. But I seriously think my favorite area is just that cute little space there. They're going to put their grill just right there in the corner. And really an awesome, awesome space. So very happy with the look. So, all right, that's it.
You know, you look at any of the top level folks and you look at the contracting group you aspire to be or you admire, is like they really didn't have a backup plan. It was kind of like, this is what we're going to do. And I got blinders on. I'm just not going any way but like making this thing work one way or another. Now, it doesn't mean you shouldn't pivot. It doesn't mean you shouldn't, you know, change course when things aren't going right. Like we pivoted away from lawn care, and it's not to say lawn care can't be profitable and you can't run a profitable lawn care company. It's just not where our desires were at that time to, and our mindset too, by the way, to grow a lawn care division to where it was self-managing with its own managers and stuff like that. Just not where our headset was at the time.